Hey, welcome back. This is episode number 42. So first I want to just talk to Bodon. Why is it so hard for me to say?
Are you sure I can't interest you in this hat?
I do want to ask you about rumors.
There's been a battle out at Winter's Breath. Several of the Benorm banded together and fought against Loghain's men. Maybe 1,000 on the field, all told. 10 Loghain won the day, it said, but there were heavy losses on both sides. It's a fight for the throne, just like in the old times. That's what I've heard on the road, anyhow. Take it for what it is.
Not what we really need right now. It's, humans fighting humans.
There's news come out of Redcliff at last. Seems that Arl Eamon has come down with some deadly sickness, probably the blight.
Yeah, we know that. But I don't think
it's
the blight.
That probably means no one else can stand up to Tirn Loghain in the Landsmeet. Rather fortunate turn for Tirn, no? That's what I've heard on the road, anyhow. Take it for what it... I'm sure you...
Oops, didn't mean to do that. Oh, well. Alright, so... I sold off some more of my inventory and equipped some more items. I kind of want to go to Soldier's Keep, but I'm afraid I'm going to get interrupted by stuff. So we're probably not going to bother with that yet. We do have some greater potions if we need them. So I'm not going to bother making more potions quite yet. And pretty soon we should be able to get the recipes for these two as well. I do have 129 gold, but because that would be all of my gold, I think I'm going to wait a little bit longer to buy that staff. And this staff has served me pretty well in the meantime. We can always give it to Morgan or Wynn afterwards. Alright, so let's head to Denrim now. Let's take Shale with us, because that's what we said we'd do. I don't remember which mage we've had with us more recently. Maybe Morgan? Let's go ahead and take Wynn then.
Yes.
And... Well, I don't know if we'll need a rogue or not. We just had Sten though. Let's take the dog. Even though he can be tanky, we'll use him as more of a DPS this time. Because there's not a very strict composition. Alright, I think we've been... Now, we could do Return to Ostagar. Actually, should we do that one first? Let's see. You know what? Let's X out of this. Let's do Return to Ostagar. Why not? Let me go back here. In which case, we will change our party around a little bit. Alistair was there with me, Wynn was there, and Dog was there. So let's take the three of them. And let's return to Ostagar, shall we? Apparently a lot of the loot you get in these places scales, which is kind of cool. Which means however high level you are when you get there will affect the quality of the loot. Random darkspawn ambush. There's a darkspawn leader back there. Alright. They're all kind of spread out. So maybe we can get a mind blast on them. Hit that one guy. I want the Darkspawn leader to come closer so I can use a thing on him. Well, see, I hate using Blizzard just because they all attack me then. Like, that's a real disincentive to use any powerful spells. Like, for a tier 4 AoE spell with a long cast time like that, it isn't worth it. It's not even close to worth it, but I don't know. I invested all those points in it. At least there is a combo you can do with it eventually, though we have a lot of points to go before we get to that point. Alright. Darkspawn leader is still not coming yet. We already used our AoE thing. Wynn, do you have one? Not really. I suppose you could earthquake them. Let's do that, since most of us will not be moving.
I am
I guess that does affect my repositioning a bit. Can we get three of them in the cone of cold? We can go us. Earthquake. I'm not going to shatter another one, but I can use my prison on this guy.
We must gain the advantage. Don't give them the advantage.
Attack. Yay, level up. Which is good, because that blizzard is not really doing much to those archers. Wow, and I'm dead. God, that sucks. Like, are they... I wish you could, like, see if target... Like, they're reducing health, so they must be standing in it, but... They seem to be, like, passing every freeze check or something for some reason. They're not taking... They're not being frozen at all. And I can't use Earthquake on them, because they're not going to move, so that won't matter at all. Oh, that sucks. I never got a chance to, Or maybe the Darkspawn leader has a bow? That would kind of explain it, I guess. Immediately. Oh. It's going to be hard keeping him alive, though. Alright, finish this guy off. And we might have to use Group Heal, we'll see. Okay, there's Herlock as well. Alright, everybody's hurt now, so let's use another potion. Oh, jeez. Actually, you know what? I'm going to try not to use a potion right away. Can you see him? You can. Alright. Oh, I have this at a different spot than I do. That's why. There we go. Finish off that guy. Duncan, go up Alistair. He's going to die otherwise. Charge. Lots of level ups, though. If we can win this. I had the Darkspawn's chasing him. Oh, now they're attacking Gwen. And she's out of magic, so... He's out of stamina. Alright, Hal, we'll see if that'll CC them for a bit. Wow, there's actually a lot of them left. Oh, I have Revive! I forgot about that. I haven't been in the party in so long. Alright. Let's go ahead and revive. Where is he? Right there. Alright, now I can use a potion as well. And can you use... Not yet, but you can use a regular heal on him. And I have a group heal. It's good to have two spirit healers in the party. Alright. I'm not going to feel bad about stacking the party with healers, because making a battle mage has not really been working for me. Unfortunately. Alright, we got that guy. Just because you draw so much aggro that way, and unless you go with like the fire line, which is just so cliche. There's just not... Oh, I'm dead again? Seriously? One guy on me and I die? That would annoy me a lot less if it didn't always come as a surprise. Like, if these were... I know I've said it before, it just really annoys me that the UI in this game is so sucky and there's nothing you can do to change it, which means I'm going to be going through all of my potions here. Alright, come on, guys. Shoot him, Wynn. Shoot him! What... Or stand there and die. That works too. Like, she's... I have her attacking him. I have it queued. She's just not going to do it. Now she's going to die. Or no, she's not dead. She's... What is going on here?
Down you go.
Something just feels really weird. I'm going to try not to, Hopefully she won't pull aggro again until she can heal. There we go. One more, guys. Right? Yeah, we're still in combat. See, and they come right to win. You're a great tank, Alistair. Just, like, stand there and let her die. God, the AI in this game is dumb. I haven't gone through and made tactics yet because... I don't really know why. I really probably should. I keep putting it off. But it's just gonna be very time consuming, and they're just gonna get more slots as they go on. We'll just have to update them. Where now? Alright, everybody up. But I will do that probably after this episode. Or after Return to Ostagar, at least.
As you say.
Ooh, a large flood crystal. There we go. But yeah. We'll just have to update as we go along. See, in my previous playthroughs, when I used to play this game, I always chose a dedicated party beforehand. Set of three people I used each time on every mission I could, at least once I got them, which made it a little easier to get familiar with their tactics and make a team that works together, whereas here I'm trying to vary it for the sake of the LP. Like, see, right now we don't have a rogue, and I used to always do. There's traps there. I used to always have a rogue. If I wasn't a rogue, I'd have either Liliana or Zevran in the party. But we don't this time. Alright, let's gather this stuff, and then I'll do some level ups. Just sucks now because we're all injured. Although maybe Wynn, is she a high enough level to choose that one skill? If so, it won't get rid of her own entries, but it'll get rid of those around her. Right, let's upgrade Dog first. I don't know if he needs a certain stat, so we'll go with, oh, he has a lot of points. I like that, because we haven't used him in a while, so we have to level him up a lot. Alright, Overwhelm is a really good ability, so I'm going to grab that. You saw the spiders using it on me, or the werewolves, whoever it was. And obviously did a lot of damage, so that's pretty cool. Wynn has 6 points. Let's put them in magic. Ho, 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 it's magic. And we're going to put them in combat training, because that improves her ability to spellcast. And if we get the second one, it'll improve her mana regen. Alright, she does have two... Ah, she needs to be level 14 for that, cleansing aura. One more level, I think. In that case, you know, I'm probably going to try to go for the AoE CC, because I don't think I'm going to have enough points in my main to get a good CC spell, or an AoE CC spell, which I'd like to, like Mass Paralysis. But, yeah, that would be so useful to have that. I'm really tempted. But, I think I'm probably just going to have Wynn get that one, and Morgan get that one. Yeah, in that case, they wake one hit. So that's definitely the better spell. Because you can put them in that, and then they can be blizzarded, they can be Tempest, which I want to get on my main. You can use Fireball or Inferno if you have it. Kind of regretting not making a Fire Mage, but that's okay. Maybe in the second game we'll do that. We'll see. If we even play a Mage there. Life Ward is really good. But I can't get that yet anyway. I think I'm going to start putting points to get her closer to Mass Paralysis. Because that's a really good spell that she could definitely use. Yeah, we're going to go for that. So she's paralyzed, weakness. And then and she could get another tactic slot just for leveling up, so that's pretty cool. I'm level 14 now, so I can choose a second specialization. So what does this do? They can learn to use their magic score to satisfy the strength requirement to equip higher level weapons and armor. Which is cool, but at the same time you still have a penalty to fatigue from that. So you have to get a lot more... It's an interesting specialization, and if you go with an Arcane Warrior, there's some definite playstyle changes you can do. Blood Mage we haven't learned and probably won't. And then there's Shapeshifter, which Morgan hasn't taught us yet. Spirit Healers is my favorite, because it has the 2 magic and the minor combat health generation and just amazing abilities, which augment normal builds. The attack I really don't care about, because that doesn't matter for spells. What's this? Constitution Armor is more defensive. Constitution and Spell Power. Stat-wise, I'd rather choose Blood Mage, but I don't really want to choose... I might choose one of these two just for the stat bonus, but I won't really use them at all. Plus 1 dexterity, plus 5 attack, or plus 2 constitution. Probably shapeshifter, but I won't invest any points in it. Which, in my first game, I had all 4 points, I remember, which was fun, but kind of a waste. Alright, let's put some points in magic now. So I could use revival, which would be really nice to have. Or should I start working on another tree? There's so many talents I want. I want these talents, I want petrify. I like Mass Rejuvenate, but that's kind of a low priority. I'm really tempted to get a Paralysis spell so I can paralyze them inside. Inside my Blizzard. But I think I'm going to start moving up the Lightning Tree next. So let's do that. Lightning, and then... Oh, it just so sucks. You can't customize the Quick Bar, you can't bind things. There's so many key bindings I would rather have here. Whatever. Alright, good enough for now. So I'm actually just going to go ahead and extend this all the way over. So we don't have to really worry about these. clean that up a bit. Lightning shock, I'd probably want to replace one of these with. Maybe numpad. Yeah. Can make this a clickable ability. We can move these far over to make space. And I assume that sticks. Yeah, it does. Alright, I'll go through and clean this up later when I do the tactics, but for now, we're pretty much... That should be pretty good. Alright, let's do a quick save. Oh, this is this encounter. Okay. Wynn, are you alright?
I fell.
I noticed. Are you alright?
For a moment there, I thought I was... I thought it was all over.
Thought what was over?
Everything. I will explain everything when we are back at camp. Now is not the time.
All right. Well, onward to Ostagar, I guess. Although at this point, we're 60 minutes into the episode and have a bunch of injuries sustained. We're off to a rough start. We're not even there yet. But that's all right. Whoop, lots of darkspawn. This should be a good party, though, and I'll probably use my an injury kit once I get 3 injuries. All right.
Shall we
go? Let's use shock. Probably shouldn't use them on the same person. Nice overwhelm, Duncan.
Something about returning here makes me feel old, Wynn.
And what exactly are you implying, Alistair?
What? Nothing. No, I just thought...
You just thought I might be an expert at feeling old. And could share some sage advice.
I just mean that I was a different person then. I believed him, you know? That it would be a glorious battle that we'd win, as you say.
Ah, key to Mage's chest. Oh, interesting. This is the prisoner, but I wonder if we... I still wonder if there was a way to free him. I didn't look that up.
We were all a little bit younger the last time we were here.
Well, not you. You've always been.
With lips like that, son, you'll be lucky if you live to be half my age.
The infirmary was here. Definitely seems like winter has come to the old place. This is a really cool piece of DLC, though. You can come back here and reclaim Ostagar, at least for a while. But yeah, I think there's actually a way to get that key to the mage's chest. See, I remembered there being something. All right. Maybe I don't know if it's only in the DLC or if you could do that before, and because we didn't do it before, we have a chance now. Can we knock it down there? I guess we have to go this way. They're trying to funnel us in one direction, it feels like. Oh, can we... I don't know where I'm going. Barriers everywhere. How do I get down there? Alright, let's see. Possibly through here? That raven seems suspicious. More darkspawn ahead.
Very well.
Let's earthquake them while they come. Oh, they're all archers. Alright, well, you know what that means. I can blizzard them and they can shoot me to death. Yep, interrupted. See, they need a ranged AoE taunt, and they need like a single target taunt, just like they have in any decent MMO. Alright, we got it that time. And I'm still alive.
Away with you!
Stop! Whoop, they have a spellcaster there too. Which one is he? That guy, I think? Chain lightning. Uh-oh. These are pretty spread out. That actually wasn't too bad. Who's shooting me? Oh, that guy. Decent range, though. kind of. Finish him, guys. What are you doing? You letting him get away? What are you doing?
I will not.
I specifically told you all to attack him. God.
We must gain the advantage.
Sometimes this,
as you say,
the game's mechanics annoy me, or the lack of.
It shall be done.
Really, I guess it's the AI that annoys me. A lot of things annoy me, but the AI most of all, I think. They just don't cooperate. Herlock Strider. Ah, Kaelin's Greaves. So that's one piece of armor.
What's the matter, Alan?
1 second. Let me look at these. Red Steel. So they're tier 5, but you can upgrade them to tier 7 using that chest back in Soldier's Keep.
I don't know. It just feels wrong to find this here. Poured over by darkspawn and thick with their rot. It was his.
I know. I feel it too. But he is not the first king to ever fall in battle, or even the first to fall to the darkspawn.
Yes, but this wound cuts deeper.
And it will bleed longer. But we must keep moving. No doubt the darkspawn are eager to give us plenty more reasons to mourn.
Try not to interrupt their conversations, but... Train Chalice. That would be a good gift for Alistair, I believe. And it may be something we actually need if we're going to replenish the Grey Wardens. Wooden crate. I also want to apologize for pausing the game in combat so much. I know that's maybe a little annoying when you're watching. I usually hate it when Let's Plays pause in combat. But like that. But this game is just so tactics heavy, you kind of have to. Alright. These are probably archers, but you know what? I'm gonna try it anyway.
I shall do it.
I have lost.
At least they got knocked down.
Concentration. No.
Damn it.
It is gone.
You know what I should have done? Oh god, see. So much aggro from that earthquake. It's just, you lose more than you gain. You really do. It's not. I should have gone for mass paralysis instead of earthquake, I think. This thing kind of cold, these guys. 3 guesses where Alistair is. Nope, I'm just dead. Yeah, he's over here, doing nothing in that entire time that the... This really annoys me. I'm gonna res him, I guess, but... The battle has been going for a good 10 seconds, and he hasn't done a single thing yet. Now I have no mana left, so I have to use a potion. Never dig it off that blizzard. Maybe I should just start having the armor at all times. I probably did have it on, though. Because usually every time I'm not controlling... Oh, that's still on cooldown, I see. There's more guys, there's more. What are you doing? See, dumb stuff like that is exactly what I'm talking about. There's an enemy standing right there and they run to me. Maybe that's a stance thing? I can't click on my enemy right now. Let's take a look at the tactics. Yeah, they're all default. I'm gonna put them on aggressive. And you actually can set a... He needs more tactic slots, too. You can set some very specific tactics commands, like if mana falls low, use potion. And once I learn some better recipes, we might actually do that. And just make stacks of potions. So that we don't have to worry about that from the other mages. Well, more.
It has begun.
Hey, get away from Wynn. Actually, I don't like having the Lyrium potion all the way over there, because... I have to move my pointer so much. Should probably just use group heal. this point. To use Mind Blast.
Off I go.
Missed!
As you say.
Get him, Duncan.
Don't give them the advantage!
Nice overwhelm. Alright, yeah, having them as aggressive definitely helps.
Back. No quarter shall be given.
And I believe, though I could be wrong, as far as tactics go. If ally... Yeah, you can set to specific people too. Which is a very nice to use a static party, but if you change it around as I do, that makes it a little harder to set exact tactics like that. The crystal for Sten. What was that? I guess she healed me or something. Oh, okay, we can now use an injury kit though. Now that I have 3 injuries. Yay. Anybody else hurt? What's this? Penalty to dexterity, that's not too bad. Alright, is this the mage's chest? No. Oh, we have no rogues here. Alright, I'll bring another rogue. Darkspawn Forge. I guess they were using this area as well. I can't do anything with it though. So when I make my tour of Ferelden with Liliana at my side, after I've maxed out her skills, I'll come back here as well. There's the mage's chest. We have a key for this one. Alright, there's some good stuff. A Charm of Still Waters, a bit of silver, Apprentice Cal, Enchanter's Arming Cap, that could be nice. Corrupted Magister's Staff, that's pretty cool. +5 spell power, 15% spirit damage, and a chance of paralysis. Some other random stuff too. I like that. It's only red steel though. So, it does have more overall spell power. Basically, I lose the cold resistance and the radiates cold isn't that good. What does it look like? Is it still a... it's one of these staffs. I might actually use it for a change and give Wynn this one. Maybe I'll give it to Morgan later, but we'll see. And use this one until I'm going to buy the best staff anyways, pretty soon anyway. And again, the best staff encourages you to be a fire spirit mage, which, I don't know, I'm thinking I should have done that, but... And a key to the Royal Arms chest. That's what we need, right? That's what we're here for, I think. No, he buried that, didn't he? Oh yeah, this is where I buried it, okay. Makes sense. But even though I regret it, I don't really regret it, because... The spells I chose, I have a certain reason for choosing, and I really would like to have a mass paralysis spell. I still may, I just ran out of points for that. I probably shouldn't have gone so high up in the healing tree before I planned it out, but
very well.
I remembered healing as being really good and I wanted to be a healer. And I guess part of it too is I'm trying to be the best of all, and that kind of makes me a jack of all trades.
As you say.
But I'm not built as a damager, I'm built as a healer who just happens to have some damage spells and some CC spells. Dead Mabari. Aww. There's some nice warp paint, though. But yeah, we are still at level 2, and we're only level like 13 out of 22-ish. So we do have plenty of time to get these, our build shape. Let's see if we can kind of hold these guys. Yeah, kind of. Light wolves. And here come the Darkspawn. Stun these guys. Ooh. Oh, we didn't get those heals off in time. Shucks. Alright, I'm gonna use Earthquake. No, I'm gonna have Wind use Earthquake. way they're all on her. Because I won't be moving and she won't be moving, so that should work out pretty well. There we go. She has paralysis. Does that actually paralyzing it for a short time? Alright, so that actually would work. I might even push this after this, whether I want to or not. But we're going to dinner anyway, and you can buy ingredients there, most of the ingredients. Blast. There we go. As you say. It just feels like plot-wise, oh, there's Kaylin's shield, we're so far along.
Shall be done.
And yet, I don't know. I don't feel like a super high level.
I shall do it.
But I guess there's still, we have all Denrim left. As we have we also have the Urn of Sacred Ashes. I keep thinking there's just Orzammar left. But we do have the whole Urn quest afterwards as well. So there is still a pretty decent bit of game left to do. And then of course the end game, which is fairly sizable, I think. So yeah. But I think I will start finalizing our tactics and all after this episode and build up a lot of potions. Or at least get ingredients for them. So that when we get the recipes, we can... I see Duncan's fire. How do we get there? Seems very conveniently blocked off. I guess we can run around here. There we go. There's Kaylin's chest.
It shall be done.
The Darkspawn have done their best to defile the bonfire where Duncan kept his nightly watch. Perhaps they still sense something of the man's power. Aww. Did you hear that, boy? That's your namesake. Probably saw him a couple times from the kennel across the way. Here's Kaylin's chest. For some reason I thought it would be at the palace, but I guess it's... Yep, there's the secret correspondences and Merrick's blade. That's a really nice sword, especially against Darkspawn. It's more of a warrior sword, but I think it pairs, as far as the set bonus goes, with the shield. Merrick's blade. Merrick is his father, obviously. The old king, Loghain's friend. And the main character of the first novel. And it pairs with the shield, though.
So it's true. He had convinced the forces of Orlais to ally against the Darkspawn.
Empress Selene was merely awaiting his response.
A response that never came, and now never will. Loghain's treachery.
That is a
never
shame.
Never is a long time, Master. Give it time.
Any high-level enemies? Nope, just all the regular ones. Alright, let's earthquake it. Why not?
I shall do that.
Put that guy in top of my prison. And those archers are going to shoot me, aren't they? Probably. I'm going to try casting. I'm probably going to be interrupted by this, but we'll see. I got it off, yay! Wow, she regenerated me, that's awesome. I'm gonna give the same to her then. Rejuvenate, whatever it's called. Okay, that was not a tough fight. It actually worked pretty well, I think. There's actually... See, I was debating between the... There's a couple different robes I'm thinking of getting. These are nice for now, but, yeah, health regen, armor, and spell power. So they're kind of a decent mix of defense and offense. There's one really good defensive robe you can get. Ooh, what's that? That's nice for a, for an archer, especially a warrior archer. And then there's a couple decent offensive robes, one probably being the best. They all look pretty cool. Whoops, we had a trap. Should have had the Liana with me. Yep, and here come the Darkspawn. Alright, Wynn, I'm going to have you use the Earthquake this time.
Ready.
Hold them off while I get ready. Now we do. And now if I can combo that... See, it'll be really great when she has Mass Paralysis. Oh, Blizzard's on cooldown. Gah! Alright. Well, let's just shock them for now then. Alright, it's off cooldown. Come at me now. Just gonna use some of those. Grasp. They're all so far away. Yeah, the abilities definitely have a longer range. Oh, now I'm knocked down by the blizzard. Or the staff has a longer range than the abilities do, which is kind of weird. Oh, he's got a ballista. Uh-oh. Oh, I love having win in the party. Chest, yeah.
It shall be done.
Yeah, I'm thinking that might be. I mean, the best party would obviously be three mages and a tank, but for some of the tougher zones, I might take one with me anyway. Because right now, things being too easy does not seem to be much of an issue, at least at this level. Maybe that'll change once we have better potions. Maybe I'm judging it too harshly too, because I'm being stingy with potions because I don't have a lot, but they're not actually hard to make. And if I did have a very large supply of them, it would make the game considerably easier. So, maybe I should be doing that. But we'll worry about that afterwards. But yeah, I'm thinking me win. I guess Liliana for her skill. I'm not sure about combat-wise, that'd be the best party, but it'd definitely be good to have her for her other skills. And then, I think Alistair or Shale both have pros and cons as a tank. Duncan's not the best tank, but he does have his charms as well. Okay, nothing over here. I think we explored everything on this side of the bridge. So onward we go. Oh, this is sad. Even the darkspawn knew who he was. Not a fitting end for a king. Especially a king of Ferelden. Feels like so long ago now. Guess game-wise is probably a year or so. They seem to imply that a while has gone by. Is that a shaman? Yep. Oh, and he's summoning undead. The spirits of dead warriors. Kaelin might have been a naive king, but he was, what we're surrounded looks like. But he was a good one. Alright, let's see if I can earthquake them. And we'll have Wynn earthquake the other side.
Your orbit ahead.
As you say.
Keep them at bay. We can even paralyze this one. Alright, so that didn't actually work out that well. Well, I got one. Where's that mage? Alright, he's being earthquaked. I'm gonna replace that with one of these, though. And a shocky shock. Because that'll drain him of some of his mana. Fireball! Even single target-wise, it does a ton of damage. Plus the knockdown? Holy crap, Firebell is a good spell. Oh, and I'm paralyzed. That too doesn't help. Alright. Wynn, I might need you to heal me here.
Direct me.
Nope. Oh, I'm just gonna die. Alright. Yeah, those two archers plus the paralyzed plus the fireball was just too much. Yeah, as I was saying about the robes, I'm debating between which to use because I really like to build. I think I'm thinking of this too much like an MMO, where I want to build my DPS as a DPS and not give them any survival traits, give them all things to increase their DPS. But because the tanks really can't hold aggro in this game like they can in an MMO, that's probably not actually... It probably is better to go for defense. So right now, he has what? How much armor does he have? 5. And I think that adds 12 armor, which is as good as like a lot of heavy armor. How much does Alistair have? 26. Big difference there. I'm just curious what his dog had. 15. He has a lot too, being a war dog. That mage is about to do something bad. I don't have a lot of mana though, so... Chain lightning. Great. Very well. Oh, he's immune. And I'm paralyzed again. Oh, I'm petrified. Dead again. Oh, this is going very poor. What, it's like, they're not even dead. What?
At your order.
I feel like Alistair and Duncan are just, like, running around doing nothing. At least this mage is finally almost dead. You two, go attack the other darkspawn, please.
Very well.
Like, this game is really not that hard. Wish the AI was like halfway decent. It'd be nicer if the challenges were actually challenging and not challenging because of the AI. Alright. And because of the stupid UI as well. It's little things like that that really get to me. Alright, but I've been complaining enough for this episode. I'm going to try to stop complaining now and get back to enjoying the game. So there's a lot we can do to better our group as well, and we'll do that after this, once we get to Denerim. Lots more potions, better tactics, better gear. Those should all help a lot. And I think we're at about the point, too, where I can start using that gear I stored in the chest. Since we've been playing the game long enough, it shouldn't outclass what we currently have by a ton. And we have enough companions where hand-me-downs are kind of a thing, too. Yay. Yeah, against like normal opponents or elites, Crushing Prison is an amazing spell. The only unfortunate part is it has quite a long downtime. I'm gonna charge in with Alistair first for a change. Charge, Alistair, charge. They're running away. They're leading us into a trap, aren't they? What was that? Oh, I think he shot his own guy with a ballista. Wow, there's a lot of them here. And I'm running into a wall. What? Where? Oh, God. This is why I hate the... I'm sorry, I said I wouldn't complain. Alright, earthquake time. Maybe. Although, if they're out there, they're not going to be... They're going to be ranged. It doesn't really matter. Group heal. Maybe I will go for Mass Paralysis and I'll give up points elsewhere. Because having the ability to stun a bunch of people at range without friendly fire and keep them damageable, that's almost too good to give up. Alright. I'm going to put that guy in a Winter's Grasp. Basically, it's going to do this the old fashioned way. Just do lots of damage, keep people healed, see what happens. Put a rejuvenate on one. And she should be able to be as well in a bit.
Watch out!
Where's rejuvenate? Oh, it's on cooldown. She already used it. Okay. Let's heal up the dog then. And this one. Oops.
Ready.
All right. Is there about 3 of them? Yeah, probably not worth using a blizzard on. So we won't. I can also use force field too. I haven't really been using that because I guess it feels kind of cheap, but it should. Because it is one of the abilities I invested in. Even though I really just wanted the
No quarter shall be given.
What's it called? Oh, watch out, Wynn. Now she's got the archers on her. Shooting.
Now we do battle.
He's healing too, it looks like.
If we must fight, let us do it quickly.
Oh, Alistair's taking lots of damage suddenly. Herlock's strategist. Haven't seen him. All right, we're running out of Lyrium potions. I might have to start using some greater ones, even though I didn't really want to. All right. I'm going to use a lesser one for now. Oh, yep, we lost Alistair. She might have to use my last Lyrium potion then, just to get to revive him. So we're probably going to need him. Where are you, Alistair? Wow, and she got knocked down, too. Alright, I need to get this strategist out of the way, because I don't know what he's doing, but it's working. Where is it? Force field. Yeah, it seems like he's a mage, and he's doing lots of bad stuff. Forget mana potion, use a health potion. Alright, he is good to go. I'm going to freeze those guys, even though it freezes Duncan. I'm going to use probably the last Lyrium potion on myself. I could do group heal, I'm not sure if it's worth it though. I'm going to put regen on Win. Rejuvenate, rather. So that guy's still over there, let's put the mind prison thing on him. That'll keep him busy. I can shatter that guy. And I can Winter's Grasp this guy. Alright, we're getting there. Oh, now she's being shot. Who's shooting you, Win? Oh, she had a trap. I'm gonna have to start using my greater Lyrium potions. God, I didn't want to do that. Okay, let's just do it. That'll be the one nice thing about having that other staff, is it gives you more mana regen. Which is really nice. The best build, I guess the reason this game is not even that hard on Nightmare and all is because if you want to go for the best build and go for like a full like Blood Mage Arcane Warrior, you make the most with that. Especially if you have a second mage on your team. In that case, the game can become super easy. I'm going to zap him with this because that'll reduce his mana. Right now he's shooting me, which is actually okay. Because dog has lesser health. Okay, now dog has aggro. Hey, we've won the day. The Tower of Ashal? Do we have to go back there again? Should I start a new episode? I don't know. Not sure how much more there is to this. There's probably at least a little bit more, though. I don't want this to be a super long episode, so yeah, let's do that. Hey, Lyrium potion, perfect. Alright, so, yep, we're going to end the episode here, and when we come back, we'll finish the return to Ostagar. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in a bit.